Aloha, my internet family. How are you? Seems like everybody has been picking up the new Prusa Mk3 lately. Today on Practical Printing, we're going to talk about how to do some basic maintenance on your shiny new printer so that you can keep it operating at its optimal performance. So you ready? Let's do this. Welcome back. Today we're going to talk mostly about maintaining the new Prusa Mk3. However, the topics that we're going to cover are pretty much relevant to any printer out there, whether it's a Prusa Mk3, a Prusa Mk2 or 2S, or an Ultimaker or any other printer that you might have. However, some of the topics that we're going to cover are right out of the Prusa handbook, but your manufacturer may have specific maintenance requirements that they need, so it's best to check with your manufacturer's documentation. If you bought a printer kit that didn't come with any documentation, today's video is a good place for you to start off with a maintenance routine. So with that, let's start off with the first item, basic cleaning. All that takes is a rag, and you just want to wipe down the printer and get the dust off of it, any little wispy shards or anything that come from stray prints. You also want to pay attention to your rods. You'll notice that it builds up hair along the rods, and you're going to want to brush that off as well. Hair or dust build up on the rods, both on each axis. Which will take us to our second topic, lubrication. Now, with the Prusa, the bearings that are included are preloaded with grease, so all you should need is a simple lightweight oil to put on your rods. So after you wipe them, you want to put some lubricant, such as I use TriFlow because it's a lightweight machine oil that's actually intended for bicycles. And I'll include a link to this down below, but it works well because it actually clings to the surface. It's formulated for that, and it's dust repellent, so it helps push dust away. Now, if you're in a house with pets or cats, this is especially important because you're going to want to make sure that you keep those pieces clean and lubricated and that it doesn't build up pet hair or dander. Which will take us into our third item. We're going to want to check the belts to make sure that they are maintaining tension, and you're going to want to take the Allen wrench wrenches that were included with your printer or your own and go through and just check the bolts on the printer just to make sure that they haven't loosened up. Now, you're going to want to do this probably once a month or so. If you're going through the process of cleaning it and lubricating it, it's probably a good time to do the same check. I would say probably no more than one or two full rolls of filament if you're pushing it and running it all the time. The next thing that we're going to do is for the Prusa Mk3, there's a little door here that I can't get off with my fingers. There's a little door here that covers the filament sensor, the little part that you slip in. All you're going to want to do with that is use canned air and just stick it in the hole and give it a blow out. While you're in there, you're also going to want to clean the hobbed gears on the extruder from both sides through the view windows. If you can either use a toothpick to do that, or if you can open it up and get a wire brush or something in there, that works as well. But you just want to make sure that you're not getting any filament buildup into the gears in there. If you need to, you can remove the two Allen keys to open up the door so that the gears aren't engaged with each other, which should allow it to spin a little bit freer. That will take us into item number 6, cleaning the hot end in the nozzle. Now, the manual recommends it, and I like to use these micro wire brushes to do that. So you'll want to bring it up to temperature, depending on if you print mostly ABS or PLA or PETG or whatever your filament of choice is, you're going to want to bring it up to the temperatures of that. You're going to raise your nozzle up to about the highest position to give you room to work. Once your hot end is at temperature, you're going to want to turn it off. And then you can, you want to tell it to no longer heat. You want to get it hot, but then you want to tell it to no longer heat. And that's when you can go in there with the wire brush and try to clean it off. Now, the reason I say that you want to kill temperature or kill the heater is because if there's electricity flowing through there and you're using a wire brush, if you slip off the top and you end up brushing against any of the wires or the cables, you could end up creating a short, which could go back and fry your board. So if those heaters are off, it's not a big deal, but you don't want to do that with them live. Which takes us on to item number 7, your electrical connectors. About every month or so, you're going to want to open up the door for your electrical box, and you're just going to want to make sure that all of the electrical connections on the motherboard are pressed in properly into the motherboard. Make sure that they are seated firmly. The printer does vibrate as it moves, which means that those connections can have a tendency to pull loose. For the wires such from the power supply and for the heat bed that are terminated on the terminal blocks down at the bottom of the board, you're going to want to give those a tug and make sure that they are seated firmly. And of course, make sure your printer is unplugged when you do all this. But if those are loose down there, you want to get your Phillips screwdriver and tighten those up just a tad to make sure that those are grabbing contact and they are solid connections. You also want to visually inspect all of your cabling and your wiring to make sure that there's no frays or anything that's loose or catching anywhere. Number 8 is bed rejuvenation. To do this with the Prusa, with the PEI bed, you're going to want to use acetone. Pure acetone without any additives to it. You can pick this up at a local hardware store typically, or you may be able to get it at a nail salon or a drugstore. You're just going to want to pour some onto a rag, and then you're going to want to scrub the entire bed with that. That will take off any buildup that your standard day-to-day wipings and cleanings with isopropyl alcohol, IPA, won't get off. And that will get the bed as close to original condition as you can get it. If your prints aren't sticking, that's the time to try to do the acetone scrub. If after doing an acetone cleaning, it's still not sticking, then it's time to look at possibly using some very fine sandpaper to resurface the top of your PEI sheet, or to look at possibly replacing your PEI sheet. Step number 9, calibration cubes. There's a link down below to a 20mm by 20mm by 20mm calibration cube. I would suggest running this about once every month or so with your filament of choice, and then checking it with a pair of calipers to make sure that you're still printing within spec of 20mm by 20mm, and that your axes are all the same. If you're finding that you're getting any kind of skew or that it's off, it may be an indication that your frame has loosened up or become unsquare, and it's time to go back and make sure that you've tightened your bolts up, and it may be time to rerun the Prusa calibration wizard. If you don't have a Prusa with a calibration wizard, it's time to look at getting out the squares and squaring up your frame and making sure everything is aligned at that point. It also might be an indication that if any of your belts might be loose or over tight or out of proportion with each other. Okay, last but not least, maintenance item number 10. You want to periodically check with your printer manufacturer to see if they have any firmware updates for your machine that is different than what you're currently running. Now, I don't recommend blindly updating your firmware. I would suggest that you read through the release notes of that firmware to make sure that it includes any features that might impact you or new features that you might want to apply. If your printer is working fine and it does exactly what you want, I don't necessarily recommend updating your firmware. I only suggest doing this if it fixes a problem or it adds a new feature that you want. Okay, so there you have it. Those are my top 10 tips. Be sure to read through your 3D printing handbook from Prusa front to back, memorize it. It is your Bible for the Mark III or your Mark II, depending on which printer you have. It is your first resource when you have a problem and when you need to check those maintenance steps that I mentioned. Those 10 maintenance steps are going to eliminate a lot of problems that you might have with your printer. And when you start experiencing other issues, that's when it's time to reach out for help. First stop is the Prusa forums or the Prusa support lines. And then of course to, you know, your other online resources. That's all I have for you today. I hope you've liked this edition of Practical Printing. If you do, please be sure that you subscribe and ring that bell down below. If you're going to be shopping on Amazon or over at Matter Hackers or any of our other affiliate sites, there are links down below. We appreciate it if you use those links. It doesn't cost you anything else, and it throws a little bit back to the channel to help us keep things running. And with that, I bid everyone much mahalo. We'll see you next time on Practical Printing.